and I'm going to present this work I co-authorized, titled Towards Extending an Omnet++ HiNet Framework for Simulating Fault Injection in Ethernet-based Flexible Time Trigger Systems. The FTP protocol project aims at providing flexibility and high reliability to distributed embedded systems. For this, we deploy fault-tolerant mechanisms on top of the FTP communication paradigm. Simulation is a good way to evaluate all these mechanisms as alternative as a prototype, because it has shorter development time, and it's easier to cover more possible scenarios, as we can force errors more easily into the internal components of the model. The FTP communication paradigm is multi-stage communication model, in which we have regular nodes called slaves that connect to a network, and we have an additional node called master that manages all the communication. The communication is organized in fixed duration slot called elementary cycles, and each elementary cycle starts with the master transmitting the so-called trigger message that instructs the slaves what to transmit during the current elementary cycle. After that, the slaves transmit their messages according to what's inside the trigger message. In the FT450 project, we used an implementation of the FTP paradigm called hard real-time Ethernet switching, or HARTES for short. The particularity of this implementation is that we have a custom switch in which the master is embedded inside the switch. Now, going to the tool we use to model, to create a simulator, we use Omnet++, which is a discrete event simulator library and framework to construct simulation models for communication networks. Models are constructed by means of visual components put together, so it's modular and quite easy to extendable to extend the models. It has support for various error models and for collecting static information. This is important for evaluating our models, and again, our fault-tolerant mechanisms. And finally, we use also the Inet framework, which is a library, an open source library, that includes a lot of components that are widely used in communication networks. This is an overview of the model we develop at the end. I will not enter too much into detail, because we have the hardest switch in the left, and then the models conforming the FTP slave. The switch can be divided into parts, depending on we have the components conforming the master itself, and also the components conforming the carrying out the frame forwarding. Then the most important modules in where we talk about for the scheduler, which construct the trigger message, taking into account the scheduling for the current elementary cycle. This trigger message is then passed to the dispatcher, which transmits at a specific moment the trigger message to the channel. In the other side, we have the dispatcher, which makes the interface which is the application and the channel, taking into account the trigger message received. And now, the first mechanism we implemented and we test in our simulator was the temporal replication of the TM, which was explained in the previous presentation. And just to remember, at the beginning of the elementary cycle, at the trigger message window, the master transmits K replicas of the trigger message, and then the slaves, when they receive these replicas, they are able to calculate when the trigger message window finished, even if one of the replicas is not able to reach the destination. So now in the model, we have two modules that perform this task, the replicator and the combiner. The replicator gets the trigger message from the scheduler and then generates all the replicas delivered to the dispatcher, and the combiner just gets all these replicas and just delivers one of them to the dispatcher, apart from calculating when the trigger message window should finish. In order to demonstrate the suitability of this methodology, we have carried out some experiments, like the one with this architecture. We have one hardware switch connected to three slaves, and each of the slaves is connected with a different link in which we have different bit error rates. We have run this experiment during 1 million entry cycle with different k values, different number of replicas, and we have get a table saying which has the probability of getting at least one of the replicas. So for instance, we know that with the decay rate of day one, we need at least 8 replicas, k equal to 8, to have at least one replica, and then that our photon mechanism will work. And if you want more details, just come to the